we're going to take a propane gas cylinder and calculate the temperature required to reach 21 atmospheres under this volume and this amount of gas. Well, let's parse the information out first and see what we need to do. And as far as why these numbers, wait until the end and I'll explain why I chose these numbers. Well, we have 5.60 moles of gas. We have the volume, 17.8 liters. We have the pressure, 21.0 atmospheres. Then what else do we need to solve this problem? Well, since there are no changing conditions, it's not, you know, pressure, volume, or temperature's not changing, that means we need to use the ideal gas constant. And recall that I like to give three values for the ideal gas constant based on pressure unit. So since this question has pressure units of atmospheres, I'm going to use the gas constant that has atmospheres in it. You can take the ideal gas law and solve it for temperature, or the way I'm going to do it, the way I discussed before, I'm going to start with the ideal gas constant and then multiply or divide until my units work. So you're either going to multiply by the gas constant or take the reciprocal of the gas constant. It all depends upon what units you want. So if we look at the problem, it does say temperature, and right now, down below, my temperature units are in the denominator, which means I need to take the reciprocal. Now my temperature units are in the numerator. Now, do dimensional analysis. Multiply by the volume. Volumes in liters, good. No unit conversions needed. Multiply by the pressure. We're given the amount of gas in moles, so divide by that. And three significant figures, because the volume, the pressure, and the moles all have three significant figures in them. And so there's our answer, 813 Kelvin. Now, always go back and check the problem to make sure we've answered the question. And while we did calculate temperature, the question did say Celsius. So we have one more thing to do. And we need to subtract off the 273.15 for the Celsius to Kelvin offset. Since 813 goes to no decimal places, it stops at the units position. When you subtract off the temperature offset, you go to no units, and that's why I've written 540 like that, to show that there are three significant figures in the 540 degrees Celsius. So why did I choose these numbers? Well, a typical cylinder for a home propane grill is a 20-pound tank, which holds about 17.8 liters. The 5.60 moles of propane, that's about 500 milliliters of liquid propane that is vaporized. And the way these cylinders work, as long as you have liquid in there, the liquid vaporizes and it gets up to a certain pressure inside the tank. And then when you open the valve and you light your grill, it pulls that vapor off. So the liquid continues to vaporize as you use up vapor, and the pressure stays relatively constant in that cylinder as long as the temperature doesn't change. And for anybody who's used one of these, you've experienced how the cylinder can go from full to empty in a really short period of time. And that's because as soon as you run out of liquid, then as you pull more vapor off, now you're emptying the tank. So it's best to have an extra tank hanging around to avoid that situation of running out in the middle of cooking. Why the 21 atmospheres? Well, on that valve, on the back side of it, is a pressure relief. And if you hit approximately 21 atmospheres of pressure in there, that means you're getting dangerously close to exploding the tank, because the tank can only hold so much pressure. So around 21 atmospheres is when that'll kick in and it'll bleed off the excess pressure. So why the temperature? What's the big deal about 540 degrees Celsius? Well, 540 is not a magic number. If you throw this into a campfire, because people go, oh, well, it's empty. There's still gas in the cylinder. It's just that the inside pressure now equals the outside pressure. So if you throw the cylinder in the fire, the gas starts to heat up. And as the temperature goes up, the pressure goes up. And campfires can hit more than 1,000 degrees Celsius. So under these conditions, if you have a little bit of propane left and you throw this thing in the fire, you can easily reach the point at which you not only trigger the pressure relief valve, but if the temperature keeps going up, you might overcome the structural integrity of the tank and you might detonate the tank. It's really, really dangerous.